Only when he sees the particular color. This first diagram This blue is BLUE is written. The color is also blue. What we see is also blue. So in fill plus, here the blue, it is written blue, but it is different. The color that we see is different, green. The person has to press only the color that he sees. So this this produces interference. The person has to think fast. This thinking skill is increased because of the meditation practice. The ability to think fast. So this is the results. The day 1, 2 and 3 without meditation practice. See, there is a the stroop reaction time, normal reaction time. It is so much more. These are the days with meditation practice. See, the stroop normal reaction time has reduced considerably. It is at a higher level on days without meditation. Whereas on days with meditation, it is at a lower level. This is the stroop interference reaction time. This is also shows that on days without meditation practice, the interference is more. There is a high reaction time. Whereas on days with meditation, there is a reaction time is fast. These are the same values table. So why this improves cognitive flexibility is the meditation activates anterior cingulate cortex and also the dorsal and prefrontal cortex. The anterior cingulate cortex is important for conflict resolution, whereas the dorsal and prefrontal cortex is important for the conflict resolution. Conflict monitoring is by the anterior cingulate cortex. The conflict resolution is by the dorsal and prefrontal cortex. These two areas are activated by the meditation. That results in the improvement in the stroke color work task. So what is the importance of this study is, so in many disorders, disorders like brain damage, dementia and neurodegenerative diseases, there is an increase in these SCWT. It leads to reduction in this SCWT by meditation practice.
I am with the please.
Thank you.
Will there be any change in these graphs because of learning curve or a period of time?
Definitely there will be effect on learning, but I have excluded that learning also.
You have excluded.
Because the practice, there will be a practice effect also. The person will be doing continuously the task and practice effect also will be there. But as you see in the graphs,
Just explain it.
The first 3 days are without meditation practice.
Yes, yeah.
The first 3 days also there will be practice effect. The practice effect we have seen is but after 3 days it has come to some baseline. And with meditation practice, the reduction is so heavy that it is definitely not due to practice. There is major effect of the meditation in addition to the practice.
What was the group study? Was it blind?
This is a...
How many students were included? You tell me what was the study control and what was the study group?
This is not a regular case control study. This is called a single subject design, where only single subject will be thoroughly studied. A number of values will be taken.
How can you go for standard deviation in a single subject?
Single subject... First three.
Standard deviation you cannot calculate. It should not come into the thing when you are including the single subject.
It will be single subject design. Standard deviation has to be calculated because cohensity and effect size are, they have to be calculated from the standard deviation.
You cannot go for a standard deviation in a single subject.
What sort of meditation?
Inhalation and exhalation.
By Dr. B.K. Dupre, a PhD student in pulmonary medicine, are all presentations of lung cancer really identical? I invite the speaker, B.K. Dupre. Dupre is here. Appalan. Please arrive in this ceremony. Reconstitution of neglected patella tendon rupture by retransfer.
Good morning. Good morning. This is about a case report which we have done at MIMS. It was done 2 years ago under the guidance of my boss, Professor Michael Sholder. This actually started when we are doing this, giving certificates for physical handicap. One day, OPD, one lady came asking for a certificate about her disability which she has been unable to walk. She said she had a history of fall 2 years ago while she was carrying water. And then she was having difficulty in extension. She was unable to do her knee extension. So we looked at it. This is a small video. Reconstruction, we use the hamstring tendons which are nearby to use this. So we made it. So we had asked what she wants. So she said, get me the knee which I had 2 years ago. That's what she gave the answer. So we looked at what are the problems, challenges. So we looked at the patella at a very higher level. So we thought we'll reconstruct the patella tendon. Though we reconstruct it, we'll find it very difficult to hold it in position. So we thought we'll protect it with some wire and then look at the knee range of movements. And then we looked at literature. Literature says there were some few things which were done in Western population who had around 90 degrees of movement. That is, they are able to bend in here from extension to 90 degrees. They were comfortable about it. So we thought we will try to achieve that and make her happy. So we went. We had opened the knee, midnet, parametal incision. The one, this is the patella. This is the tibial fibrosity. This is all the gap in between. So there was no patella tendon actually. So it's all free area. So we took semitensile stresses tendons from here. We have harvested those tendons. This one is semitendinosus, the big one. The fine stress tendon is here. We took both these tendons, harvested them, made nice loops, and then had made it a band wiring, so kept the patella in position. And this is the semitensile stresses graft which we had inserted. Now we thought we had done a good job and then looked at the movement of the knee. And in the post-op period, after day 3, we started our mobilization and looked at the knee. So what the knee is about. We were very happy about the knee range of movements. We thought she was very comfortable. And then by the time they were discharged, we'd ask her Date 12, she said, I'm not willing to go. I'm not finding it comfortable. Then we found out the reason was, till then she was using for her nature call, she was using her knee in flexion position. In hospital, she was using Western Comfort. Now she found it very difficult. So we said, we'll do aggressive physiotherapy and all. So we requested her to stay for a few more days, started her at physio. We discharged her back and brought her back after a few days. And then after 6 weeks, we removed the wire and all. And this is the final result which we had achieved. to the patella canal. The patella canal is supposed to the four which can be seen is the insertion of cementate stenosis. This is what we have got here. And now, this is what is the final result.
Congratulations for your nice work.
Now, we're going to discuss